You are watching the Rhoda Wilson Show, and we are delighted to be back again with a brand new series. For the next few weeks, we'll be talking to great guests who are looking to inspire you by telling you all about themselves and their businesses. Also, we have a new section called Opinion Point. This is where the Rhoda Wilson Show is on the streets of London, asking the public for their opinion on various questions. So stay tuned. My guest today is Abina Pokua, who is the founder of an organization called Oema Oheni. Is that correct?
Correct, yeah.
And welcome to the Rhoda Wilson Show.
Thank you very much.
I mean, you actually founded this following your redundancy. As a designer,
yeah.
You decided to start up your own business. What is the inspiration behind this?
It was really tough. I mean, the recession started last year, and yeah. I was made redundant as a designer. And I've always wanted to have my own label. Being from a Ghanaian family, I've always been surrounded with beautiful West African textiles, and studying fashion at London College of Fashion, I've always wanted to pursue that career. So I think that the redundancy was a gist in the right direction. You know, maybe perhaps it was God's will to make me get the strength to go on and do it,
yeah.
and be bold, not sit at home and be depressed. and basically, the inspiration behind the brand is to create clothes for young women who are, you know, not necessarily from a West African background, but for any woman who enjoys colourful design, who enjoys style, who mm-hmm. wants to be glamorous, wants to be professional.
Yeah.
So I always basically create garments that have a West African influence, you mm-hmm. know, not always Ankara, but you can always tell it's an Oema Oheni product, you know, from small detailing. But that's the inspiration behind the brand, you know, Ghana.
Yeah. Yeah. So this is one of your designs.
Yeah. Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about this design.
Basically, this is from the current Autumn Winter 9 collection.
Yeah.
And the inspiration behind this is basically party wear, Christmas season.
Yeah.
And it's basically using Ankara, but this is a special fabric. Obviously, it's got stretch. Yeah. And most Ankara is always 100% cotton. So I've developed the fabric so it's more wearable, more functional.
Yeah.
You know, so it's a Western style, but with, you know, the gist and the joy of Africa.
Yeah.
So it's basically a party dress for Christmas.
But I really do like it. I like the purple colour. It's not like, yeah. you know, which means that you can wear it year round
of
as
course,
opposed
yeah.
to just wearing this during the
classic,
summer.
It's a classic yeah. style. I mean, autumn, winter, these are the colours that are going to be in trend, purples, metallics.
Yeah.
But obviously it's transitional. You can wear it into spring, summer 2010, should you wish to do so. But it's a fun, happy, you know, young, fresh design that makes you feel confident, sophisticated.
I like the way she's obviously, you know, accessorized it, because she's got the pearls,
yeah.
and then she's got the pearls in the hand, pearls in the necklace as well.
Yeah.
And so therefore, I mean, it's nice. You can wear it to weddings.
Yeah.
You can just about
Definitely.
Wear it anywhere else, you know. So that is very, very nice. Do you, when you say you designed it yourself to make it stretchy, what do you mean?
Basically, I work with a lot of people, but I source my Ankara fabrics, and what I do, I reproduce them.
Yeah.
So I've designed my own Ankara at times, and have it printed at the beginning stages with Lycra.
Ooh.
Rather than using 100% cotton.
So are you what? So, just I'm still paused. How do you go through that?
And basically, my background is fashion, and I yeah. study service textile. So it's just a process of printing. Rather than printing on 100% cotton,
yeah.
you print with a Lycra blend. So it's 3% Lycra with that yeah. Cotton. So it's just an ordinary process of printing, but just using a different fabric.
Okay. I see she's going to change for us in a minute, and,
yeah.
and obviously we've got another design as well to come on. What is the inspiration behind this particular one we're going to talk about?
Well, basically, this again is from the Autumn Winter 9 collection,
yeah.
and the sleeves are Tudor inspired.
Because okay.
obviously I've been brought up in the UK, so obviously I like English heritage and, you know, English period costume.
Yeah.
So I've used that influence with Ankara,
yeah.
you know, so it's an unusual concept of using Ankara with, you know, a modern day westernized style,
yeah.
but then using some, you know, influences from the Tudor period,
yeah.
with the big sleeves, Tudor sleeves, big buttons. Mm. So it's a wearable fun coat. You can wear it as a dress if you wanted to.
Yeah.
It's actually quilted, it's probably too warm for a dress, but it's a great winter coat, keep you warm. Something a bit special. Every winter you want something special, you know, that's an investment. You want something that's going to stand out.
But wouldn't you, I mean, I could wear it as a dress during the summer. I suppose during the winter you could probably need to wear like a sleeve inside just to cover the long part.
Yeah, I mean,
of
for like a long sleeve jumper or
yeah.
a t-shirt, some high length boots, you know, so put the collar up, you
yeah.
know, feel a bit snug.
It's quite a sexy outfit because you could go clubbing with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, you just don't have to wear it as a coat.
No.
You could wear it as you see, like a dress with a high heel. And, you know, do your hair. Hey, hello. You dance all night away, you know. So that is actually... But your colours, I mean, you always go for the bright colours too. You still
yeah.
like, get influenced by... by the, because most people probably go for black or brown.
No,
or,
I mean, Africa's full of colour, full of joy, so I like to celebrate this with my fashion. Yeah. So obviously these are actually colours that are current for autumn winter 2009. Yeah. So big designs like Marc Jacobs, Yves Saint Laurent, they'll all be using these colours this season anyway. Yeah. So it's even a benefit that's also colours that are reminiscent of Africa.
Yeah. But that is, and so your models, so you see you have lots of people you work with, how do you work with them? What kind of things do you all do together?
Basically, what I do is I try to work with a lot of my family members, because when you run...
Well, it's cheaper.
No, seriously, the one thing I found with doing the business, yeah. I've been working full-time to support the business, you know, doing like temping roles, anywhere, anything I can find, I'll do it, just to help pay for the label. You know, and models are quite expensive. I tend to use like new models who don't mind to collaborate, you know. Yeah. Use my little brother to take my photographs for me, my older brother to do the website for me. Yeah. You know, anybody who I know, I grab onto them, you know, because you have to save money. Yeah. So wherever I can, I always work with people who are looking to also climb up so we can climb up together.
Yeah.
You know, so we're both in the same kind of boat. We haven't got much of a budget, so we can work together and both get an achievement from it. You know, I want photographs, you want photographs, yeah. I want photographs, so, you know, work together.
To make it work, yeah. Really. I know whilst we're talking about that, we've got some shoes as well, yeah. Some of the prints, so we're ready to see those. We've got, like, you've got three there.
Yeah.
The first one is, what is that shoe?
The basically, they're all batik pumps, okay. And it's just a classic product. You know, you go to any, from when you, like, you know, in primary school, everybody wears pumps to school. Yeah. But I thought, wouldn't it be interesting to have like batik ankara pumps? You know, mm. it's never been seen before. No, you can't get them anywhere. Yeah. And they've been selling really, really well.
Yeah.
Basically, this line is for my diffusion line called O. Mm. And what I do is I use the leftover from the fabric, from the clothing, mm-hmm. and produce shoes from that. So it's basically a sustainable line.
Yeah.
And it's a fun line, you know. Who wants to wear a plain pair of pumps? You want a bit of colour,
yeah,
you know, wear a pair of jeans.
Jazzy.
Yeah, jazz it up.
Yeah, but that is great. I suppose this is more for summer wear.
It's more for summer wear, but actually I've got some winter ones as well, like darker colours.
Okay.
And they're actually unisex, so you
really?
Can, whatever you are, male or female, if you're 5 years old or 50 years old, you can wear them, you know?
Yeah.
So it's a product that reaches to almost all demographics.
Yeah.
So it's doing really well. It's been in the papers, it's been quite well publicised, but it's nice to see things in the shop and see people wearing your things, because you think, okay, all this suffering wasn't for nothing, you know.
Yeah.
So it's exciting to see things moving forward.
Now let's come back to the business side of it.
Yeah.
You are fairly young, you know.
Yeah.
You've gone on and started your own business because you obviously wanted to influence the fashion world, the way
yeah.
people dress, and so on. How do you, I mean, are you a limited company? How do you?
Yeah,
you know?
My business is a limited company, and what I did was, when I was growing up, I knew I wanted to have my own business eventually. So I did like business studies A-level, did art, textiles A-level. Then I went and did fashion at London College of Fashion. But basically, I've always sought advice from people who I thought could help me.
Yeah.
Like I have a friend who's an accountant. So anybody who has something who could help within business terms, I seek their advice. I can't afford to pay for advice. But I also joined an institution called the London Youth Support Trust.
Yeah.
And they help young people under the age of 30 to set up their own businesses. So they give you guidance,
mm-hmm.
They give you rental space, a cheap rental space to house your business. So, I mean, I wouldn't say, I think it's more common sense has got me to where I am. I won't
yeah.
say I'm like, you know, I'm not Sir Alan Sugar. Not yet.
Not yet.
One day, you know, be Dame Alan Sugar, I don't know. But it's been difficult, but it's more of a case of budgeting and knowing where to spend the money, what products to produce. A lot of people want to be designers for fun.
Yeah.
You know, want it for a livelihood, you know, to build a future, you know, have plans to eventually go to Ghana, perhaps have a school there in Ghana, you know,
yeah.
to encourage the industry there, the fashion industry there. But it's mainly just, it's difficult, but I seek advice from many different bodies
yeah.
to try and get me to where I am now.
But you must be doing very well because, you know, you've been shortlisted for the O2 X Awards.
Yeah.
What is that?
Basically, O2...
And first of all, what is O2? And then you can tell us how you came about being shortlisted.
Yeah, O2 is one of basically the largest telephone companies, and
yeah.
they've got together with Grazia magazine and Time Out, I think it is.
Yeah.
Shortlist, sorry. And they've awarding young people who basically trying to achieve goals in businesses and do well.
Yeah.
And I've been shortlisted for the Young Entrepreneur of the Year award.
Wow.
And should find that in October, hopefully.
Oh my God, how did they find out about you though?
Basically I applied. Basically it's an open application.
Okay.
You send your business plan and you tell them about yourself and they go and research you. And when I got the email, I was in my pajamas working on the laptop. Like, oh, it's like a scream. Like, oh my God! So I was really proud. My family's really proud. Obviously, they're coming. Yeah. I'm a second generation Ghanaian, so for them, I'm achieving things that they didn't think was possible.
Yeah.
So everything that I achieve, they're really happy and really proud of. So again, when I win something or have nomination or shortlisted, it's a proud moment for my family, not just for me. So everything I do, it's not just for me, it's for my family as well.
Yeah. Abina Fukua is here with us. So she's going to sit here because she's going to tell us what the future holds for her or what she expects the future to hold for her. So please do not go away.